begin in the U.S., where a new coronavirus variant discovered in California is being blamed for a surge of infections during the Christmas holidays. Here's the full story.
As U.S. coronavirus vaccination efforts ramp up, a growing number of virus variants could challenge the public health response. Researchers at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles told Reuters that a new coronavirus variant found in California drove a surge in cases during the Christmas New Year holiday period. Dr. Jasmine Plummer compared the Cal20C variant to another highly contagious mutation, first discovered in the United Kingdom.
We're learning a lot from the strains. If we look at the UK variant, we're actually learning that it's more infectious.
On Sunday, CDC Director Rochelle Walensky said there are over 1,000 cases of the British coronavirus variant known as B117 in the United States. She added that it may become the dominant strain by the end of March. The highly transmissible South African mutation was also detected in the United States at the end of January. Reuters data on Sunday showed there were more than 27 million coronavirus cases in the U.S. The nation's death toll is steadily climbing toward 500,000. Rite Aid CEO Hayward Donegan on Sunday said vaccine supply has so far been unable to meet the demand. She added that private sector pharmacies would be best equipped to help with regards to scheduling vaccinations, which is so far still in the hands of state and local jurisdictions. Late last week, U.S. President Joe Biden said the U.S. would have enough vaccine doses for 300 million people by the end of July.
New Zealand's largest city goes back into lockdown after three members of a family tested positive for COVID-19. It's the latest setback for the island nation, which is considered one of the most successful countries in controlling the spread of the disease. We have this report.
New Zealand's Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern on Sunday announced a three-day lockdown in the country's biggest city, Auckland, after three new COVID-19 cases emerged. They're the first local infections detected since late January. Ardern said level three restrictions will require everyone to stay at home except for essential shopping and essential work.
3 days, though, should give us enough time to gather further information, undertake large-scale testing, and establish if there has been wider community transmission. That is what we believe the cautious approach requires and is the right thing to do.
She went on to tell the news conference in Wellington, quote, "We've stamped out this virus before and we will do it again." Sunday's cases were traced back to a couple and their daughter in Auckland. Health authorities are trying to find out whether they involve any of the new highly infectious variants that have been found in other countries, including the UK and South Africa. The COVID-19 alert for the rest of New Zealand was raised to level 2, with all gatherings limited to 100 people, including at restaurants and cafes. The country is due to start inoculating its population of 5 million with the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine from next Saturday.